So we don't have to fear the judgment of God here or the punishment of God, which does not mean that you will never experience the discipline of God. Because there is a difference between discipline and punishment. Mm-hmm. Oh, how I wish the world understood that. Yes. Because they have, the world and the church has seemed to accept this greatly, to wipe out the concept of discipline or being a disciple. Disciple. Because that's too harsh, that's too rough. The fact of the matter is, it says that God disciplines those whom he loves.
If he doesn't discipline,
you're not a son of him. You're not a child of his. Okay? Mm-hmm. That's not punishment. It is training.
Yes.
It is training in righteousness. That's what discipline is. Okay? It is correction. Discipline encourages what's being done right, and discipline corrects what's being done wrong. Mm-hmm. It's about training in righteousness. We should see David sought discipline. He prayed for discipline and said, let not my head reject it. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's the attitude that we have. That's the attitude of the righteous. It is a humble attitude.
Yes.
When you recognize that you need God's training in your life. You need his discipling in your life. You need his discipline in your life. The fact of the matter is that the devil has tried to change and corrupt. He has not tried. He has been all too successful
yeah.
in corrupting the language. So we have difficulty communicating.
Yeah.
Right? Don't just put yourself in a place where you say, okay, I'm not going to reject discipline. Put yourself in a place where you pray for discipline.
Yeah.
The discipline of the Lord in your life. Because that's the purifying thing.
Mm.
That's when God comes and he's pointing out or showing or dealing with us of the things that are not right in our lives. So that's what we should desire.
That's dross that comes to the top.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Through the heat?
Well, it is through the heat. Refiner's fire.
That's right.
God, you know, said Job, it's in the book of Job, you know, I know that when I've been tried, I shall come forth as fine gold. When gold is tried, it is heated up, it's put to the fire. So that, as Alan said, the dross, the impurities rise to the surface where they can be scraped off.
Mm-hmm.
I can remember years and years ago, you know, when I was first saved, and I was praying, God, you know, I want to be what you want me to be, Lord. I want, and I could. It says, you know, I don't try and hide my failures from the Lord. What a silly thing that would be. So, you know, if there was something in my life that I recognized that was not right, I'd be praying, Lord, help me get this out of my life.
Mm-hmm.
Help me deal with this or deal with it for me, Lord. Mm-hmm. And the next thing I know, it's getting worse.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, well, you know, what's going on here? Well, I know what's going on there. Mm-hmm. Is God was dealing with it.
Yes.
He was bringing it to the surface where he could scrape it off and get rid of it. So I'm not encouraging you to try and make your sin worse. But I am encouraging you to confess your sins one to another, to be faithful to confess your sins to the Lord, and to seek his discipline in your life, his cleansing power of love in your life.
Yeah.
Okay. So all of that said, the Lord is, as I said, he is obligated to his word, to the promises that he has made. He's obligated by his word to the promise that he made to Abraham, right?
Mm-hmm.
He said, and I will bless those who bless you. And the one who curses you, I will curse. And all the families of the earth will be blessed. Hallelujah. I'm an adopted son of Abraham. I now worship the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and his son, the promised Messiah of Israel. If God's promise was to bless Abraham and his lineage, his descendants, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you see that those countries that we just talked about, that God is speaking against, is bringing his judgment on, they're all the nations that surround Israel.
Hmm.
Hello?
Right.
All you Ammonites, you Edomites, you Philistines, you Bingoites, all of you ites out there that are not in a right relationship with the Lord. You are in perilous danger. And the only way to escape is to change fathers,
mm-hmm.
because the church, the curse of the father is passed on generation to generation.
Mm-hmm.
Change fathers. Take the father, accept the work of the father in heaven. Change countries. How can you change countries? Because our citizenship, it says in Philippians 3:20, is in heaven. We're ambassadors for Christ. We are transformed. We're new creations in Christ Jesus when we accept his work, his life in us, right?
Yes.